Come, Holy Spirit, come fill my heart, refresh my soul.
This is your season of grace with your host, Patrick Henry Edet. Get ready for Grace Revolution.
Two kinds of people I want to share with you. One category of human beings, those who are small, and they are comfortable being small. Take note so that you will know where you belong. Small and comfortable. Hungry, comfortable. Poor, comfortable. Sick, comfortable. They don't have what they desire, what they need in life. They are small, but they are comfortable. It's a category of people. But there's another category of people, those who are big and uncomfortable. They are large and hungry. They are tall and ambitious. They are big, large, and yet hungry. The other ones, they are small, but comfortable. If you are small and comfortable, prayer cannot help you. Prayer gives you opportunity. Because there are very wicked people who are very prayerful. They rise every midnight and pray, but their lives have never changed. For decades, they are the same, just that they are very prayerful. Prayers open doors, give you opportunities. It takes something beyond just praying to become something in life. If you hear me, say, I have heard it. Prayer gives you opportunity for change, but you need to take advantage of that opportunity to actually change. You can pray forever, you don't move the hand of God. Revelation. And acting upon revelation. That's what moves the hand of God. And prayer will set you up for revelation. So prayer opens up to the divine. Prayer gives you open heaven and gives you revelation. But if you don't apply, if you don't drag revelation into your life and make revelation your life, your lifestyle, you will remain the same. What killed others will kill you with all the prayers you pray. So prayer opens the door for you, but you must be the one to take action to go through the door. Am I talking to somebody? So I'm talking about those who are small and comfortable. If you are small and comfortable, you can pray every day till you die and nothing will change. Why? Because you are comfortable. It takes a hungry person to get out of the house to look for food. It takes a hungry person to ask somebody a question. What can I do to deal with this or that and that? It takes a hungry person to look for direction. It takes a hungry person to say, if I die, I die. A comfortable person says, let me die. A hungry person says, I will try. If I die there, I die there. But a comfortable person don't no need to try. Let's die here. So hunger and comfort. I want to talk about the category of people that are large, big, mighty, and hungry. If you see a man who is mighty and hungry, be careful. He's a dangerous person. Somebody who is big and hungry, they are the changers of the world. They are those who get things to happen. Small, comfortable people cannot change life. They change nothing. Hand over a situation to them. They cannot increase it. The highest thing they can do is to maintain it. I'm likely, very likely, they cannot even maintain it. The house of Joseph, the tribe of Joseph, was the double portion of the house of Jacob. You see, Reuben was the first son of Jacob. But Reuben failed. The biblical principle is that the firstborn is the one who takes the double portion of the father. That means the first son is the other people times two in his portion. His other brother times two. But because Reuben broke the principle of honor, tell somebody honor. The word honor has to do with weight. With weight. To honor somebody is to acknowledge the weight of somebody. Is to acknowledge that somebody is weighty, is heavy. Heavier than you. Weightier than you. So when, for example, you are sitting in a place and you see an elderly woman or anybody you recognize is bigger than you, who comes, and you stand up from that place, do you know what you have just done? You acknowledge the person has more weight than you, is heavier than you, that the person matters more than you. And the person sits, assuming you don't even know what the person can do, but you just recognize, and the person sits. Now, the likelihood is this: everything that depends on the person to use his weight to do, he will use his weight to raise you, because you recognize his weight. The other side is the truth, that you don't recognize the weight of the person. When the person has opportunity, he can use his weight to crush you. Am I talking to somebody? So when you honor God, you defer to his weight. You know, when it comes to financial issue, you recognize the weight of God, the weightiness of God over your life, and you give him his portion, you give him his place. That means in any situation that it demands only the weight of God to raise you, he will use his weight in your favor because you acknowledge his weight. That's what I discovered as I studied honor. So Reuben broke the principle of honor. He went and slept with the slave girl, one of the slave girls of the two women, the mother married to that child or had children. Each of those two slave girls had two children for Jacob. So Reuben, being a firstborn, had grown. So he shared in the fun of the father. Shared the same woman with the father. The father did nothing. But on the day that the father should have used his weight to raise him, to install him as the head of the family, the father used his weight to crush him. He said, turbulent as water, you Reuben, you shall not excel. Be careful what you do with those who are bigger than you. For their weight can either raise you or crush you. Am I talking to somebody? Don't break the principle of honor. Because the one you honor, even if the person does not stand by you to raise you, God will cause another person who has weight to raise you. Don't break honor. Tell somebody, don't break honor. Young people, young girls, young boys, talking anyhow, doing things anyhow. There comes a day you need a weight to raise you. And you wake up such day because you never respected weight. You never honored weight. The day you need weight, weight does not help you. So Reuben failed. And the father transferred the double portion to the 11th son. Your portion will not be taken from you. Yeah. So Joseph, in Genesis chapter 48, from verse 1 to 5, Sometime later, Joseph was told, your father is ill. So he took his two sons, Manasseh and Ephraim. Say Manasseh and Ephraim. Manasseh. Along with him. Verse 2, when Jacob was told, your son Joseph has come to you, Israel rallied his strength and sat up on the bed. Jacob said to Joseph, God Almighty appeared to me at Luz in the land of Canaan, and there he blessed me and said to me, I am going to make you fruitful and will increase your numbers. I will make you a community of peoples, and I will give this land as an everlasting possession to you, to your descendants after you. Say, this land. And he said to me, I'm going to make you fruitful and increase you and give you a possession of the land and your descendants. Now then, your two sons born to you in Egypt before I came to you here will be reckoned as mine. Adoption. Say adoption. This is where you have the principle of adoption and divine adoption. Joseph is one of the tribes, one of the sons. But Jacob is doing something. From you, I take two. I pray in the name of Jesus that you will have two. Amen. That you will produce two. Amen. Two is double. Amen. The scripture says two are better than one. Say, now then, your two sons born to you in Egypt before I came to you here will be reckoned as mine. Ephraim and Manasseh will be mine, just as Reuben and Simeon are mine. By this, he gave them the same rights. It means Joseph instantly has double rights. It means the double portion that Reuben will never have is given to a man. What you lose, it's already belonging to another person. That's why don't lose. If you are careless and you lose, don't think that's all. Somebody is always taking from who loses. The next verse. And any children born to you after them will be yours in the territory they inherit. They will be reckoned under the names of their brothers. I share with you what I call, if you need space, if you need more space, then take the forest from the giants. In case your space is not enough for you, then take the forest. In case your space is not enough for you, then take the forest from the giants. Let's go to Genesis chapter 49, 22 to 26. Still talking about Joseph. Say, Joseph is a fruitful vine. A fruitful vine near a spring whose branches climb over a wall. With bitterness, archers attacked him. They shot at him with hostility. But his bow remained steady. His strong arms stayed limber because of the hand of the mighty one of Jacob, because of the shepherd, the rock of Israel, because of your father's God who helps you, because of the Almighty who blesses you with blessings of the heavens above and blessings of the deep that lies below, blessings of the breasts and womb. Your father's blessings are greater than the blessings of the ancient mountains, than the bounty of the age-old hills. Let all this rest on the head of Joseph, on the brow of the prince among his brothers. Shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, when you are blessed, it comes with something. It comes with some pain. When you are blessed and you increase and you expand, it comes with some issues. When you are blessed, you will need space. Am I talking to somebody? I say, when you are blessed, blessing comes with pressure. Tell somebody, pressure. Look at the blessing poured upon one man, double portion. Blessings of heaven above, blessings of the deep, up and down, left and right. Where will you keep the blessing? That means you need space. You see, blessed people, everywhere they go to on earth, they are under pressure. Those who are blessed, wherever they go to, they are under pressure. Blessed people, wherever they go on earth, they are under pressure. If you are blessed and you are listening to me, your office is smaller. It's too small for you. Why? Because people think you are already too much. I don't know when I'm talking to somebody. If you are blessed, blessing comes with pressure. That is why many blessed people, they feel they are under curse. Because wherever they go, they face hostility. Wherever they turn to, they face opposition. Why? Things don't like to give them room. People don't like those who are blessed. People are more comfortable with those who are small. Somebody who is a blessing is a threat. The reason is because when you are blessed, you have increase upon you. You expand. Others are thinking one, you are thinking seven. And when somebody is happy with one and you are demanding seven, somebody is angry with you immediately. Is it the only one? Blessing puts you under attack. Go among the gifted. Blessing makes you a problem to those who are already big. You walk into the office of somebody who has been comfortable until you came. Now that you are here, somebody feels little. Somebody feels threatened. And you'll be wondering, is it this little me? Shut up. You are not little because you are blessed. Can you imagine that blessing? Did you see that blessing? Can that blessing make somebody small? Verse 22. Joseph is a fruitful vine. A fruitful vine near a spring whose branches climb over a wall. With bitterness, archers attacked him. Did you hear that? They attacked him because he's a fruitful vine. When you are fruitful, you increase, you expand, you look for space. When a blessed person comes into your room that was already small is shut down. Who can come here? Who can more? I thought you were coming alone. He said, I'm alone. But with all these things, say, they are mine. There is no space for you here. You go into offices, that's what people tell you. No space for you because you come with things. He said, but we were expecting you to come alone. He said, but I'm alone now. He said, no, all these things. Tell somebody, all these things. So fruitfulness makes you come with all these things. You go to school, all these things. Your classmates don't like you. Even your friends behind you is not happy with you. When you fail once, they are happy. At least, how can I fail? Those who are really blessed, most times they don't have friends. They only have people who smile with them. They don't really have friends. Many people whom you may think they are your friend, they are not your friend. Behind you, if you hear what they say about you, and the reason is just because you are blessed. I don't know whether I'm talking to somebody. People are more comfortable with people they can pity. So this issue is a serious thing. With bitterness, archers attacked him. They shot at him with hostility. But his bow remained steady. Why? Because he's blessed. His strong arm stayed limber because of the hand of the mighty one of Jacob. The one who gave you the blessing is still in the business of keeping the blessing. That's why you don't have to be afraid. Glory to God. Because of the shepherd, the rock of Israel. Look at the next verse. Because of your father's God who helps you. Because of the Almighty who blesses you with blessings of the heavens above. Blessings of the deep that lies below. Blessings of the breasts and womb. Your father's blessings are greater than the blessings of the ancient mountains. Than the bounty of the age-old hills. Let all this rest on the head. Let it rest on my head. On the head of me. On the brow of me, the prince among his brothers. Now, where do you expect Joseph to keep all this blessing? Now you know. Among his brothers, where you tell me. Ask somebody, where will he put all this blessing? That is why after all the prayer you pray, all the anointing, all the sowing, when the fruits come, they begin with attack. They begin with issues. Friends turn against you. People are more likely when you also fail. Because you take space. Those who are blessed, you occupy space. What five people take, one person takes, will you be happy? You yourself, will you be happy? You see, even you yourself, you are not happy. So where will Joseph keep all this? The fact that every circumstance you are fruitful. Where you are expected to die, you rule. Where you are expected to beg, you give. Where you are expected to kneel down, you stand. Where you are expected to be frustrated, you are in a speed. You know, when you are living that kind of life, there are people, no matter if you give them yourself, they will not be happy with you. If you cut off your leg to sacrifice to make them happy, they will be even more angry with you. Joshua chapter 17, verse 14 to 18. If you have written down, now look at the screen. The people of Joseph said to Joshua, "Why have you given us only one allotment and one portion for an inheritance? We are numerous people, and the Lord has blessed us abundantly." These are the sons of Joseph. They are complaining to Joshua. Joshua was the man, the commander who gave the portion. He took instruction from Moses. God blessed Moses. He went and rested. He didn't have additional trouble. But Joshua had trouble to settle nations, tribes. And the sons of Joseph, they were angry. You cannot treat us the way you treat others. That's the problem with blessed people. They are not comfortable with what makes normal people comfortable. Now you know why people don't like blessed people. You know why witches actually attack blessed people. Occult people attack. Even friends attack their blessed. Everything is against a blessed person. It takes God for a blessed person to survive on earth. If you are blessed and you don't know God, you will be poor. Because the reason why you are attacked is because you are blessed. Your salvation is in God. Tell somebody your salvation is in God. Be careful when you are blessed.
This program is sponsored by the Covenant Friends and Partners of Grace Family Global Outreach. You can be part of this grace revolution by becoming a Covenant Partner today. Allow God to use you. Our account details are as follows. Bank, Zenith Bank. Account name, Grace Family Global Outreach. Account number, 101-42-978-63. For inquiries, please call 081-804-33225 or 090-738-38742. To all our Covenant partners and friends, we say thank you. Like the widow of Zarephath, your oil will never run dry. To order for the books, messages, and other resource materials, please call or send an SMS to 080-660-46346 or 081-804-33225. Videos are also available on YouTube at www.youtube.com/Grace Family Outreach. To stay connected, like us on Facebook at Grace Family Outreach or visit our website at www.gracecommission.org.